It's Friday, and it seems it's sort of last presentation, so I really do appreciate you are here, guys. Thank you very much. And the good news is that I heard 20 minutes ago that I got additional 4 hours to speak, so this is the good news. So, my name is Balázs Hambalkó. Thank you for having me. For me, a little bit, some information. I started working in the IT security field 18 years ago with reverse engineering. The most couple of years I do penetration testing and vulnerability assessment in the banking and government sector inside the outside of Europe, which means I do internal and external infrastructure level penetration testing, vulnerability assessment on critical web application and core banking system, MSSQL configuration reviews, and last but not least, exploit development. I don't mention the Wi-Fi hacking. Everybody do Wi-Fi hacking. Okay, let's try it. Okay, it's working for me. So, I learned that in spite of spending a lot of money for some IT security products, the level of security won't be outstanding at your company unless your IT people change your approach, their approach, and expand their skills. They need a deeper understanding in IT security, and of course I'm not talking about performing penetration tests, okay? So, I classified the so-called problems into three groups: the operation-related issues, lack of proper knowledge and approach in case of IT security, and I would like to share with you some so-called workarounds I came across in 2017. Okay, let's start with the operation-related issues. Up to this day, I meet Windows 2003 servers still, which are available on the internet, from the internet. And I found sometimes on these machines, web applications, of course, using really sensitive data such as employees' personal information, salaries, and so on and so on. And usually clients say that we haven't got hacked so far. Hard for me to believe. Maybe they just don't realize they got hacked. Anyway, they say we won't change anything until the first incident. I met Windows 2003 servers inside the corporation server LAN 2. Here in this story, the IT staff tried to protect these kind of servers by blocking the SMB v1 vulnerable protocol on the firewall.